probably the biggest category in terms of patients that proceed to bronchoscopy where there is a suspected malignancy or cancer. So in those circumstances, we would use the CT scan initially to plan the procedure, and that will enable us to know exactly where to target the bronchoscopy. What I mean by target is, of course, when you put a flexible telescope into someone's airway, then initially the main airway is a single tube, and then it splits to right and left, and then there are numerous subdivisions on either side. Now, the CT provides invaluable information as to which particular airway or road to navigate. So, as I've mentioned, the bronchoscopy enables us to target, to go to exactly where the disease is, whatever that might be, and then to perform a variety of biopsies. We use a variety of drugs, just a cocktail of two drugs, in fact, which enable us to perform the procedure with you in a very relaxed state. The other thing that we do, which enables us to perform the procedure without the patient suffering or worrying, is to anaesthetize the upper airway. So we introduce some local anaesthetic within the larynx itself, and allow a couple of minutes for that to take effect. And thereafter, the combination of the upper airway being anaesthetized, in combination with the drugs that we give the patient to feel extremely relaxed, allows us to put the telescope in and have a look around and do all the biopsies that we need to do. The patient is unaware that the procedure has started. Often when we finish and tell the patient how it went, they seem surprised and ask when we're actually going to start the procedure. And you know, that is the ideal scenario.